Aloha YouTube, what is up? Untitled Way here, coming at you with a sneaker mystery box. Finally, after 2 weeks, I apologize for not having mystery boxes the last 2 weeks, but as you guys know, I had to like kind of conserve money for a little bit to help out a family member. So that's why we didn't see mystery boxes, but this one's gonna be a good one. It is $1,500 from Soul Supremacy. So that is right over here. Huge box, gonna be a lot of great shoes and stuff in there. And we'll be getting into that real quick. But before we do, I wanna give a huge shout out to the sponsor of today's episode, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community that offers thousands of classes ranging from design, videography, photography, and so much more. And I honestly think that it's such a great service because a lot of people always ask me like, how do I start up a YouTube channel? Or how do I take the best pictures on Instagram because I want to be an influencer? And I tell them all the time, like, you got to start learning the craft. You got to take it seriously. You got to treat it as a job and you got to really like dedicate yourself to the craft. And that's why Skillshare is amazing because it's all online. You guys can learn it really quick and the instructors on there can really teach you what you want to know, which I think is really good. So if you guys want to start up a YouTube channel and need to learn about videography, there's classes on there for that. And I actually just finished a class on Skillshare as well. This one was called iPhone Photography, How to Shoot and Edit Conceptual Photos on Your Phone by Ameli Setzker. And this was a really awesome class because I know another barrier for a lot of people that want to get into the influencer game and stuff is they don't have the equipment necessary. But Ameli in this class shows you that you can just use your iPhone to become like the next big Instagram influencer because you can take really, really crazy pictures with just your iPhone. You don't need like this high-tech gear and stuff. So I highly recommend you guys check out that class. It's a really good one over there. And before I forget, one of the other great things about Skillshare is that it's extremely affordable, like extremely, extremely affordable. It's literally less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. And I think that's an absolute steal. And what's even better is the first 1,000 people to use that link in the description below will actually get a free trial of Skillshare premium membership, guys. So you guys want to hit that link now. First 1,000 people get to try it out for free. So make sure you guys hit that link and check out Skillshare today. Anyway, let's get into this mystery box now. $1,500 from Soul Supremacy. First mystery box in 2 weeks. So I'm expecting some crazy shoes in here. Let's see what we got. Okay, so let's check out some of the shoes in here, guys. First one out of the box is this, a size 11.5 Jordan 11 low. Ooh, nice. We have a pair of the Cherry 11 lows, or alternate cherries. I can't remember what this one is called, but this thing looks like it is dead stock, which is crazy. Oof, but I don't know if... See, this is the problem with shoes like this. I'm not really sure if it's considered DS or not, just because there's like some kind of like color fading on it. And I'll show you guys under the camera what I mean. Like if you check out this shoe over here, this has like a little bit of discoloration over here on the top, which is very, very unfortunate. But I do think that this is still a DS shoe. I don't see any markings on the bottom or anything. No sock lint on the inside. Doesn't look like there's any creasing on the patent leather either. So it is a dead stock shoe, but this discoloration that's kind of going on, I'm not sure if that's gonna make it difficult to sell in like places like GOAT or StockX, just because, I mean, it really varies on who the authenticator is. So that's a hard one, but I do sell these shoes on my web store, untitledway.com. So if you guys are in the market to get shoes like this, it's probably gonna be a lot cheaper than what the DS pricing is. So that's why it's good for you guys. Next shoe is a Jordan box. This one is a size 9.5 Jordan 13. Oh, wow, another cherry. We got a whole bunch of cherries in this video today. So this is the Cherry 13, I believe. This one is definitely not dead stock though. First worn shoe of the box. Bottoms are definitely dirty. Upper doesn't look too bad though. I mean, like, you guys check out the leather and stuff on this. Doesn't look too worn. And the suede doesn't look too damaged on this either. So a pretty solid shoe, guys. Jordans is really what you want in like mystery boxes and stuff, just because no matter what version of the Jordan it is, I mean, Jordan 1s obviously is the best you can get in a box, but like 13s, 12s, 11s, 5s, whatever it is, all Jordans sell because everybody loves their Air Jordans, and no matter what, you'll find a buyer for it if you're patient. So this one will definitely move. Cherries, I think, are pretty decently hyped though, so this one won't last very long on the web store. Dude, we got a lot of like these old school Jordan boxes. This one is a Jordan 2, size 9.5. I'm guessing it's a red and white one. Watch this. Oh no, okay, so it's not, we don't got cherries over here anymore. This one is a black pair of Jordans. This is actually not too bad. I haven't seen this colorway before. This one is worn, but in really good condition as well. I mean, the bottoms, obviously you can't do anything about that. Dirty. But the upper, I don't see any markings or anything bad on this. And this shoe is from 2010. So even though it's 10 years old, it still has a really good look to it. So this is another good pickup. And as I mentioned, Jordans sell. So that's a good one for the counter as well. Okay, and so next one, we got a Yeezy 350 box over here. This one is a size 6 though. And for this pair, we have a pair of the Sesames. Honestly, still one of my favorite Yeezys. I'm not a huge, huge Yeezy fan, as you guys well know, but this was one of the ones that I did have in my personal collection at one point, and I really like this pair just because even though it's like a neutral pair, it just really works well with a lot of fits and stuff. So nice pair over here, and the condition of this one is ridiculous. Like, check this thing out. No issues on the upper at all. Even like the inside lining and stuff doesn't look too worn. If you guys can kind of peep right there where it says Adidas Yeezy, If this is worn down, that's how you know it's been worn a lot, just because the foot will like rub over that Adidas Yeezy a lot. But this one looks perfectly fine. And bottoms kind of tell the story that this one also wasn't worn too much. Boost over here is like fully intact and it's not like it's run down or anything. So really nice pair over here, and probably a much better steal than if you had to buy the S. So great pair to see. I think we got like four more shoes. This one is a Jordan Spizike though, in a size 9. Don't like Spizikes. Oh, okay. And man, I don't know. I know a lot of people really like the Spizikes. It's just not for me, man. I know it's supposed to be like a hybrid shoe, but I don't know. I just really don't like the Spizikes. I think they're really like, I just feel like they're really like wonky looking, you know? Like, I don't know. That's my own opinion. I know you guys are probably going to flame me for that. A lot of people love the Spizikes, but my own personal opinion. Anyway, check it out. Jordan Spizike. Like I said, it's a hybrid of the 3, 5, and 4. You guys can kind of see accents all over the place from those different models of shoes, all made into one like crazy hybrid looking sneaker. Solid condition on this one. Uppers don't look too bad at all. Bottoms look pretty dirty, pretty worn, but not too much star loss on the top. So that's also a good sign that it hasn't been worn too much. I'm not really sure what the Spizike market is nowadays. I don't think they make the Spizikes anymore, but like I said, there's a lot of people that do like this shoe, so this one should sell pretty easy as well. 3 shoes left. This one is a Jordan 8, size 10. We got a whole bunch of Jordans in here today. That's cool. Oh, okay. And I think these are called the Aquas. If we're talking about a beater box, this one is pretty beat. You can see there's a lot of cracking over here on the midsole. A lot of cracking, actually. And these bottoms are super dirty too, so not super good on this. But even with all of that, I still think this will fetch at least $100 or so. Jordans really don't like lose too much value. Like even if you wear them and stuff, just because the market is so huge for Jordans and everybody wants a pair, they'll sell for at least $100. Like no matter what pair it is, that's how I feel for most shoes. I've seen that time and time again. Like every shoe that I think won't sell, it ends up selling. So that's one that I don't think is super hype, but it'll probably sell pretty quick. Okay, 2 shoes left. And this one is a Jordan 4. Size 9.5. They literally gave us like almost every single Jordan pair except a Jordan 1. But that's a good mix of shoes, so we got to see the whole gamut of Jordans. This one is, ooh, wow, okay. This is a good shoe right here. Jordan 4 White Cement, guys. This thing is sick. And I believe this is the 20... Oh no, this is the 2012 version. Okay. I think there's still a lot of good value in here. The 2016s go for a lot of money, but the 2012s, it's a little bit different, but still pretty good value here. Jordan 4 White Cement, a classic sneaker. You guys can check this one out. Looks really solid all over the place. Don't see any issues on this at all. Even like the toe box and stuff, very minimal creasing, so that's good to see. A bunch of socklet in the shoe, and bottoms, kind of dirty, so not good right here. I don't know what this is either. I hope that's not like a band-aid or something. That's disgusting. I'm putting that back in the box, man, and I'm washing my hands after this heavily. That's really gross. But yeah, still nice to see a Jordan 4 White Cement. Okay, and so to end this $1,500 box, this is a shoe that I normally would bring out in the beginning, but I figured it was the money shoe of the box. This one does not have a sneaker box with it, but I already know it was probably gonna be the hype pair of the box, because this is a pair of Tiffany SB Dunks. But this one, dude, the condition is pretty bad on this. Oh, this is such a heartbreak to see. This is why I get really sad like when I see Tiffany's like this, because Tiffany is like one of my favorite shoes of all time, right? But this one, man, I gotta show you guys under the camera what I'm talking about. It's heartbreaking. It makes me sad. This swoosh over here is made out of like metallic silver, and it's well known that this thing does break up over time, like no matter what you do. But this, man, this, like, oh, this is not good to see. I don't like that. It's really making the swoosh look terrible. Really like destroys the value of the shoe when you see it like that. But still, no matter what, I mean, it is still a Tiffany Dunk SB. Really iconic shoe, and these things aren't being remade. So if you guys want this, this is the kind of stuff you have to put up with. Can't really do too much about that. Overall, not in really good condition. I can't even put a number on it. Like I was gonna say 7, but it's really hard to say just because you gotta kind of tailor your expectations with this shoe, right? Like no matter what, you gotta realize this is from 2005, I believe, 2006. So it's 14 years old. It's not gonna be the prettiest shoe, but if you guys are looking for a cheap pair of Tiffany's, this thing I'm sure is not going for super crazy prices on the counter. Good value in my opinion. Anyway, that is it for this mystery box, guys. Really interesting end to the box. Like, I don't know. I felt like it was going to be a really strong shoe at the end, but that swoosh just makes me really upset. But no matter what, a couple $100 over there. So still a good way to end it. And it was a good diversity box where we saw a whole bunch of different Jordans. And I think almost the entire box of Jordans except for one pair of Yeezys. So this makes it a very easy to move box. Anyway, that is actually it for this video, guys. Thank you guys so much for waiting 2 weeks for the Sneaker Mystery Box series to come back. I actually have two more boxes coming in as we speak, so there should be boxes every single Friday, at least until the end of the year. So that's a good thing to see. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you guys did, don't forget to hit that like button down below. Appreciate all you guys behind the camera. And until next time, guys, stay humble, stay blessed, take care, and I will see you on the next episode. Aloha. Shoot!